Hello everyone, welcome to the e-lecture series on design and analysis of algorithms. Myself Professor Rutuja Jadhav, assistant professor from computer engineering department of KKWAG Institute of Engineering Education and Research, Nasik. So today the topic of discussion is greedy method and the knapsack example using greedy method. So these are the contents of today's discussions. First we will have a look at the greedy method. Then we will see how to solve knapsack problem using greedy method, and one example we will solve. So let us begin. First we will discuss about the greedy method. So greedy method basically works in stages. At each stage it is considering one input at a time, and a decision is made whether this particular input satisfies some constraint of the problem or not. If it satisfies the constraint, it is placed into a set called as feasible solution. Once you have computed the feasible solution, then we check for the optimal solution. So feasible solution which either maximizes or minimizes the given objective function is called optimal solution. So basically the problem will have n inputs, then you will construct a set of solution called feasible solution. It is the set which satisfies the constraints of a given problem. Then out of the feasible solutions, you will find out the optimal solution. So how you will find out the optimal solution? So it is nothing but the feasible solution, which will either maximize or minimize the objective function of the given problem. Okay, as I mentioned, it works in stages considering one input at a time. Okay, and the input is arranged in some particular sequence. So this is what is the general method of the greedy algorithm. Now let us see the control abstraction of the greedy method. So this is the control abstraction, or you can say the algorithm for the greedy strategy. So here algorithm greedy parameters are A, N. So A is an array, one dimensional array, which is containing N inputs. Solution vector is initialized to phi, that is null. For all the inputs, so there is a loop for I is equals to 1 to n, do x is equals to select A. So from this input vector, we are selecting one input at a time with the function called select. Then we are checking if feasible solution x, solution comma x, whether this input A, which was copied in x, is giving you the feasible solution. If yes, then we are storing that solution in the solution vector with the function called union. Okay, so union solution comma x. So we are adding this solution in the solution vector. So for all inputs, for all the n inputs, we are going to check whether it is giving you the feasible solution. If yes, it will be placed in the solution set, which is nothing but the feasible solution set. Then as mentioned earlier, once the feasible solution is obtained, so depending on the problem type, whether it is of the type optimal or whether it is of the type maximization or minimization, accordingly you will select one of the feasible solution, which is either maximizing the output or minimizing the output. And finally, return the solution. So that is what is the greedy method. So basically you will go for the greedy method when the given problem type is of the type minimization or maximization. For example, minimum spanning tree. So in this case, you are trying to obtain the tree of minimum cost. So the problem is of the type minimization, right? For such type of problems, whenever you are interested in finding out the optimal solution and the given problem is of the type minimization or maximization, at that time you can go for greedy method. Now let us see the knapsack problem. So first we will discuss what the knapsack problem is. So knapsack basically, we are given n objects and a knapsack. Okay, so there are n objects and each object is associated with certain weight. So object I is associated with weight wi and also profit pi. So there are n objects, each object is having certain weight and profit associated with it. Then there is a knapsack bag. So knapsack is nothing but a bag which is having certain capacity. So let us say M is the capacity of the knapsack. Then for fraction, if certain fraction of the object, let us say x is an object, okay, ith object, okay. So if fraction of xi is placed into the bag, then you will be earning a profit called pi into xi. Okay, so the objective of the knapsack problem is to fill the knapsack in such a way that it maximizes the total profit earned. And also there is a constraint that total weight in the knapsack should not exceed the capacity of the bag, which is M. So I hope you have understood the knapsack problem. There is a bag, there are objects. Each object is having certain weight and profit associated with it. If you place that object into the bag, then you are going to gain some profit. And the problem is you have to maximize the profit. Okay, how much profit you are going to earn? So if you are putting a fraction xi of an object, then you are going to get the profit as pi into xi. So whatever fraction you are placing into, whatever profit is associated with that object. All right, so this is the knapsack problem. Now, in general, we can see the formal definition of knapsack. So knapsack problem, in general, we can say the problem can be stated as to maximize summation of pi xi. So what is pi into xi? So we have seen x is the fraction of the object that is placed into the bag, and pi is the profit associated with that object. Okay. So what is the problem? Problem is to maximize this profit earned. How much profit we are going to earn? We are going to earn the profit pi into xi for all the n objects. Whichever objects will be placed in the bag, for those objects we are going to earn the profit pi xi. Summation, because addition of the objects and its profits, right? So we have to maximize the overall profit earned by placing the objects into the bag. Okay, but simultaneously we have to check that it is not exceeding the capacity of the bag. Okay, so we have to add the objects in the bag, considering that it is not extending the going beyond the capacity of the bag. So whatever is the wi xi, what is wi xi? It is the weight of the object I and how much fraction you are placing of the object I. Okay, so wi xi will give you the weight in the bag. So that should not exceed, or it should be less than or equal to the capacity of the bag, which is M. All right. And then next, you have to focus that xi values, that is the fractions are allowed. So the values will be from 0 to 1. Either you cannot place the object, so value of xi will be 0, or you can place the value. So place the object completely, so its value will be 1. Or otherwise, if you are placing the fraction of the object, then its value will be between 0 to 1. Okay, depending on what fraction you are placing into the bag. So this is the formal definition of the knapsack problem. Let us solve the example so that it will be more clear. So see the example. Consider the following instance of the knapsack problem. N is equals to 3, M is equals to 20, P1, P2, P3 is equals to 25, 24, 15, and weights W1, W2, W3 are 18, 15, 10. And we have to find out the feasible and optimal solution for the same. Okay. Now, when we have seen the the greedy method, we have said that the problem of the greedy method considers the input in particular sequence, right? So here, if you see the example here, you can see there are three objects given. So N is equals to 3. Capacity of the knapsack is given as 20. Profits of these three objects are given as P1, P2, P3, which is equal to 25, 24, 15. And weights of the objects are given as 18, 15, and 10. Okay, we have to find out the set of optimal solution, a feasible solution, and also the optimal solution. Okay, now, as per the greedy method, first we will arrange the input in certain sequence. So what are the possibilities of placing the input sequences? So there are various possibilities. First, we will see. Now the profit is, we want to maximize the profit, right? So it is of the type maximization problem. So what are the possibilities that we will get the maximum profit? So if you arrange the input sequence in the order of decreasing order of profit, then there is a chance that you may get the maximum profit, right? So first we will see the case one. So there are three ways of solving this example. Okay, so first case one we will see by arranging the input in decreasing order of profit. Okay, so decreasing order of profit. So if you see the example P1, P2, P3, it is already in decreasing order. The profits are already in decreasing order. 25, 24 and 15. Okay, so if you arrange in decreasing order, which is the first object? First object comes out to be W1 or rather object 1. Okay, what is the weight of the object 1? Object 1, its weight is 18. And what is the capacity of the knapsack? Knapsack capacity is 20. So can you place the first object completely into the bag? Yes, because object weight is 20, which is lesser than the capacity. So we will represent our solution as the x1, x2, x3. x1 is the fraction of first object, x2 is the fraction of second object, x3 is the fraction of third object, right? So yes, we can place the first object completely. So that is why in place of x1, we will write it here as 1, right? Now, what is the capacity remaining? If you place the first object into the knapsack bag, what is the capacity remaining? So 20 minus 18, that is 2. Only 2 units of space is remaining in the knapsack bag. Okay. Now, let us consider the second object. What is the weight of the second object? Weight of the second object is 15. But what is the capacity remaining? Only 2. So how many parts of second object we will be placing? Whatever is the capacity remaining divided by whatever is the weight of the second object. Remaining capacity is 2 and divided by what is the weight of the second object? It is 15. Okay. So 2 by 15 parts of second object is being placed in the knapsack bag. Now what is the capacity remaining in the knapsack? 0. Now there is no place in the knapsack bag. So can you place the third object in the knapsack? No. That is why we will write it over here as 0. So this is our solution vector. First object is placed completely. Second object is placed in the fraction 2 by 15. There is no place for third object. So it is 0. So if you compute Wi, Xi, so it comes out to be 20. That is, we have not crossed the limit of the knapsack bag. Okay. And what is the profit earned? Profit earned is we have to calculate Pi, summation of Pi, Xi. So first object, what is the fraction of the first object? It is 1. So 1 into profit of first object, that is 25, plus what is the fraction of the second object? 2 by 15. So 2 by 15 into what is the profit of second object? It is 24. So if you calculate it, it comes out to be 28.2. So the total profit earned using this method, that is by arranging the input in decreasing order of profit, you will get the profit as 28.2. Okay. This is one way. Now the other way, what can be the other way? So case two, arrange the input in increasing order of weight. If you arrange the input in increasing order of weight, what will happen? You will get maximum number of objects placed in the bag, right? So again, we will represent the solution vector as x1, x2, x3. x1 is representing the fractions of first object. x2 is representing fraction of second object. x3 is remaining representing fraction of third object, right? So if we arrange the input in increasing order of weights. So which object to be considered first? First object is having weight 18, second object is having weight 15, and the last, that is the third object, is having the weight 10. So this is the object having less weight. So we will consider first third object. So what is the weight of the third object? It is 10. So what we will do, we will place the third object completely into the knapsack bag. So that is why in the fraction of x3, we have written 1. 1 represents completely placed in the bag. 0 represents it is not placed in the bag. And otherwise, if any fraction is placed, that we will be writing. Okay. So we have placed third object completely into the knapsack, which was having the weight 10. Okay. What was the capacity of the knapsack? Knapsack capacity is 20. So 20 minus 10. Now what is the capacity remaining? Again, 10 units of capacity is remaining in the bag. Right. Then next, which is the next object in increasing order of weight? So second object is having the next increasing order, next increasing weight. Okay, that is 15. So can you place this object completely into the knapsack? No. Why? Because the capacity is remaining is only 10. Okay, and whereas the weight is 15, so you can place the fraction 10 by 15, and if you simplify it, you will get 2 by 3. Okay, so what fraction of second object is placed? It is 2 by 3. Now the knapsack is completely filled. Yes. Is there any place for the first object now? No. So you will place over here as 0. Okay. So if you compute summation of Wi Xi, now it is equal to 20, which is the capacity of the bag. Okay. And if you compute now summation of Pi Xi, that is the total profit earned. How you will compute? Summation of Pi into Xi, P2 into X2 plus P3 into X3. Okay. What is P2? P2 is 2 by 3. And what is X3? X3 is 24. So 2 by 3 into 24 plus X3. What is X3? It is 1. What is P3? It is 15. So 1 into 15. So what it comes out to be? 31. So if you arrange the input in increasing order of weight, you will get the profit as 31. Okay. In earlier sequence, in the earlier case, that is decreasing order of profit, when we have arranged our input in decreasing order of profit, we have obtained the profit as 28.2. But if we arrange the input in increasing order of weight, we are getting a profit of 31, okay, which is greater. Now one more possibility is arrange the input in according to the decreasing order of profit by weight ratio. So you are given profit as well as weight. So what you have to do is compute the ratio of it. Okay. So compute ratios for all the three objects. Okay. So what it will be? 25 by 18 for the first object, 24 by 15 for the second object, and 15 by 10 for the second object. So calculate it further. If you simplify it further, these are the values that you will get. 1. Okay, so likewise, you have to compute the profit by weight ratio. And if you simplify further, you will get the values 1.38, 1.6, 1.5. So now you have to arrange this in decreasing order of profit by weight ratio. So as you can see, 1.6 is the greatest. So you will consider the second object first. So this is first object, second object, and third. So 1.6 is greater value. So you will consider the second object first. Now what is the weight of the second object that we will see? So here you can see weight of second object is 15. Capacity is 20 and the weight of second object is 15. So we will place now first the second object. Okay, so again we will represent our solution with the same vector, same format, x1, x2, x3. Okay, so second object is placed completely into the bag, so that is why 1. Okay, so now what was the capacity? 20. So 20 minus weight of the second object. What is weight of the second object? 15. Right, so 20 minus 15. So now what is the capacity remaining in the bag? So 20 minus 15 is equals to 5. 5 is the capacity remaining. Now next object to be considered is the third object, because its profit by weight ratio came out to be 1.5, which is the second highest, right? So third object you will consider now. What is the weight of the third object? It is 10. What is the capacity remaining inside the bag? It is 5. So what fraction we will place in the bag? It is 5 upon 10, which is nothing but 1 upon 2. Is there any place remaining for the first object? No. That is why 0. So this is our solution vector x1, x2, x3. So 0, x1 is not placed into the bag. Second object is placed completely into the bag. And third object, 1 by 2 fraction of the third object is placed into the bag. Okay. So this is the solution using profit by weight ratio. Now what is the thing you have to calculate? First you have to check WIXI. Summation of WIXI should not be greater than 20. So it comes out to be exactly 20. and then calculate the profit earned, total profit earned. So what is the formula? It is summation of PI into XI. So P1 into X1, it comes out to be 0, plus P2 into X2. What is the profit of the second object? It is 24. How many part of the second object? 1. So 24 into 1 plus P3 X3. What is profit of the third object? It is 15 into X3. What is the fraction of the third object? 1 by 2. If you simplify this further, you will get the profit as 31.5. Okay. So if you compare the three methods, so these are the three techniques by which you can compute the solution for the knapsack problem. So if you compare, so if you arrange the input in decreasing order of profit and then try to solve, you have earned the profit as 28.2. If you arrange the input in increasing order of weight, then you have earned the profit as 31. And if you arrange the input in decreasing order of profit by weight ratio, profit earned is 31.5. So this is our feasible solution set, which is having three values. That is 28.2, 31, and 31.5. So this is our feasible solution set. Then depending on the problem type. So in this problem, what we are supposed to do? We want to maximize the profit. So which type of problem it is? It is maximization problem. So out of these three values, that is out of the feasible solution, you have to find out the solution which is having maximum profit. So you can see by decreasing order of profit by weight ratio, we are getting the maximum profit, that is 31.5. So 31.5 is our optimal solution. So I hope you have understood the knapsack problem and how to solve using greedy method. So there are three cases of solving. First is arrange the input in decreasing order of profit, then obtain the solution. Second case, arrange the input in increasing order of weight and then obtain the solution. And finally, the third case, arrange the input in decreasing order of profit by weight ratio and obtain the solution. So you will get the set of three values, which will be our feasible solution set. And out of that, you have to select the maximum value, that is the maximum profit earned. So as you have noticed that this profit by weight ratio method gives you the maximum profit, that is the optimal solution for this problem is 31.5. Okay. Now this is one practice problem for all of you. So you have to solve the example with the three cases mentioned just now. Okay. Solve this greedy knapsack and you can comment your answer below the video. Okay. So that is it from my side. Thank you.